Now get this, the United States is the number one trash producing country in the world at just over 1,600 pounds per person per year. Environmentalists say plastics and other waste are becoming more difficult to discard, and Americans, as well as other countries, will need to embrace a zero waste mentality. Joining us from our New York studios for more on the subject is Gail Barnes. Ms. Barnes is a technology and sustainability expert. Gail Barnes, welcome to the show.
It's wonderful to be with you.
It's great to have you. Listen, what is causing the global increase in the production of waste?
We are consuming more than we should. And when it comes to recycling, China has recently, the ban went into effect on the 1st of January, said that they will no longer be accepting other people's trash, which makes it so important that we need to take personal responsibility for creating less waste. And I've got three ideas for you today to share
and
that will make that possible.
Tell us some of the ideas. How do we do that?
The first thing we can do is to compostable lunch, for example, where
so much
plastic is just not recycled. And particularly flexible packaging is not recycled. So when you pack a compostable lunch and everything in there, from your orange to your snacks, which may be in packaging, is compostable, this is a really good thing, because afterwards, after you finished your lunch, your food scraps, your fruit peels, and your compostable packaging, for example, I've worked extensively with a company, a startup in Israel called TIPA, T-I-P-A, that makes a compostable packaging with breakthrough technology that allows you to put it into the compost.
Okay, so tell us about some of, there are some countries that have banned plastic, the use of plastic, such as Rwanda. Why is plastic such a problem?
It's a problem because it's a problem to collect, to sort, and to recycle. It doesn't matter if you're in Rwanda or Johannesburg or somewhere in the United States. Only a fraction of the trash, particularly plastic, that is collected is getting recycled. And it's even worse when it comes to flexible packaging. The number is really, really low. So then it comes back to, as I said, personal responsibility.
And what are some simple ways, perhaps best practice, when it comes to recycling? Because some people still do not understand what it means and how do you recycle properly.
Recycling means that you take a product like a bottle or a can, you put it into collection, it goes somewhere, and it's either broken down mechanically or chemically into a material which goes into other materials or back into the same. Composting is when you take food waste, natural materials, and compostable packaging, for example, using the TIPA technology.
Okay.
Back to the soil.
One of the solutions you encourage is green living. Quickly, because we don't have much time left. What is green living and how does it make a difference?
When you go out jogging, instead of just jogging, plogging, pick up litter as you run. Unplug on autopilot. Your devices are still pulling current when they're plugged in. Get a plug that will turn off after a certain period of time. Don't waste energy. Green living is about being thoughtful about what you use, using less.
Okay, so one final word about best ways moving forward to prevent so much waste.
How to prevent more waste?
Yes, one final word.
Compost.
Right.
It's a natural solution.
Great. Ms. Gail Barnes, thank you so much for joining us.
You're so welcome. Thank you.
And that was Gail Barnes, as she is a technology and sustainability expert. Remember to recycle and compost.